This is not what I
expected.
Hold on.
Let me get a little closer to you. Okay, when you talk, you gotta face me, Lance.
Oh, sorry, Brandon. The upload's finally suffering a little bit. We've got three walls between us now. Like, what? Do you wanna see my Wi-Fi? Obsolete! At least, that's the goal. ASUS sponsored this video, and we're gonna be taking our first look at the Zen Wi-Fi Pro ET12. The first empirical proof that I've seen that Wi-Fi has completely jumped the shark. That's right, my friends. This is a $900 wireless router. Well, actually, there's two units. Wireless solution for handling anything from a bungalow all the way to a 6,000 square foot residence with just these two admittedly very attractive base stations. $900.
Yep.
How could you justify that?
It looks so cool.
Oh my God. Are those the antennas?
Yep.
Wow. Okay, that's kind of cool. Also, there's a lot of tech inside them. This is insane. I mean, part of the reason that it costs so much has got to be that they effectively just ship you two of them. Here, do you see these antennas, Andy? Antennae? I can tell you part of the reason for the high price is that they literally ship you two of them. Can you buy it at one? Oh, it's a two pack. That's the ET12, is the two pack. Two pack is alive. You saw it here first. It's an older meme. Taken from us too young. I think we can all agree on that. All right, before we explain why you might need two of these, let's talk about why one of these base units might be worth about $450, starting at the back. For wired technology, right out of the gate, it's better than your average wireless router having two 2.5 gig Ethernet ports. This is gonna be great if you've got a greater than gigabit internet connection, which I just got installed at my house, 2.5 gig internet inbound, or if you have a couple of key clients that might need to run at greater than gigabit speed. Say for example, if you had your main computer that you use as an editing station in your home office and a high-speed NAS that you use to store high-resolution pictures or high bitrate video. It's got a couple more gigabit ports, all the usual power in, WPS, on and off. Does that just enable and disable like the whole unit? Other than that, it's got a nice aesthetic, which I guess is cool. And of course, it is jam-packed full of the latest wireless technologies. So this isn't just Wi-Fi 6, this is Wi-Fi 6E. And that's a really big deal because while it's more of an evolutionary step forward, it's built on the same fundamentals as Wi-Fi 6, for you, the end user, it could actually be a bigger upgrade compared to going from Wi-Fi 5 to Wi-Fi 6. When we went from 5 to 6, the biggest benefits were in households with many connected devices, whether that's a lot of users or whether that's a lot of IoT devices, smart locks, smart blinds, all of that kind of stuff, because it allowed much more efficient use of the available spectrum. It also adds new security features and all that kind of good stuff. But where Wi-Fi 6E changes the game is it's actually adding more spectrum. That's right, 6 GHz is finally here. So we've had tri-band routers before, 2.4 and then in most cases, dual 5 GHz bands. But this tri-band router is 2.4, 5, and 6 GHz. And what's cool about 6 GHz is not only will it never be cluttered up by legacy devices, so this is entirely fresh spectrum for those new devices to communicate on, but it's also way wider than what we had before in the first place, which isn't to say that it doesn't come with some disadvantages. Because the frequency is even higher than what we had before, yes, you might see a really nice speed benefit. On a supported client, though admittedly there aren't many yet, you could easily see throughput in excess of 1 Gbps and even to multiple clients. This features a 4x4 design on both the 5 GHz and 6 GHz bands, but it does come with a drawback. So remember how 5 GHz didn't have the same kind of range and penetration power of 2.4 GHz because the frequency's higher? Well, 6 GHz is higher again. So you're gonna get that lightning fast speed and lower latency, but it will come at some cost in terms of range. And I think really that is where a lot of the value add of a package like this comes in. ASUS is acknowledging that the kind of person buying a premium wireless access point like this one may want that kind of speed across their entire domicile, or, I mean, realistically, you could use a product like this in a small business if you really wanted to. And that's what makes this product really cool. So, because both of them have dual 2.5 gigabit ports, what you can do is you can actually configure it a number of ways. You could say, okay, hey, I want my modem to plug into this one, and I'm gonna put this over at the other side of my house, and I'm going to have a bunch of devices connected to this one, a bunch connected to this one, and I'm gonna use a dedicated wireless backhaul between them. That's cool, that's great, but it means more hops, which means more latency for any devices that are connected through the second access point. What you can also do is create a dedicated wired backhaul between them, which is a lot closer to what you would do in a commercial environment, so you can actually get full speed on every wireless device that is connected to either of them. Pretty sick. Speaking of hardware, each of these units has a 2 gigahertz quad-core ARM V8 processor inside. Like, that's the thing, is really the main benefit of a product like this is gonna be connecting many devices. ASUS sent over internal shots of it. That is so cool. There's some other software features to talk about. Obviously, it uses ASUS's extremely robust web UI, and they've got a cool VPN feature that allows you to VPN through your own home internet connection, no matter where you are, which means you don't have to even trust a VPN company with your data, and ASUS would have no access to it, which is pretty cool. And my laptop just booted up. Let's see, do I have a Wi-Fi 6E chipset in here? Hello? Yeah, I'm just Wi-Fi 6, not Wi-Fi 6E. And that's something to note. If you want to take advantage of Wi-Fi 6E, so the actual 6 gigahertz band, you're going to need a device that was built from the ground up for it. It's not just a firmware that you can flash onto your old Wi-Fi 6 devices. But that's a feature, not a bug, because like I said before, it means that your Wi-Fi 6E devices will not be sharing any of that airtime with older legacy devices. Man, 6E is going to be just such a godsend for people living that apartment life. Like, you don't probably realize how much your neighbors just having a bunch of wireless gear kicking around is affecting not just the throughput, but most importantly, the latency of your wireless gear and the consistency of your connection. So if you're trying to do something like stream video, I would expect to be able to do it at least until 6E gets super crowded, though that should take a really long time. I mean, we get 7 more 160 megahertz channels, like, that's freaking insane. Well, hey, in the meantime, why don't we get this powered up? What's their setup process like? Oh, cute. It's got like RGB lights in the top. Check that out. Oh, wow. Okay, it does not look like it's flickering like that in person. Okay. WAN goes here. I don't know, Andy, do you want to come with me?
Our internet box is over here.
Hey, boys.
Hello.
Is this the longest cable we got? Yeah, I just have to hit that TELUS box. Yeah, right there. Gosh darn it. Okay, where's our longest cable then? Oh, that?
Yeah, that's the last one we got.
That does not look longer than what I have.
All the other ones are at your house.
Yes. Okay, well, let's make the trek again. And I ran out. This one is even shorter. Okay. It's coupler time.
Can I help
you? Oh, good, yes. I need a coupler for Ethernet.
Oh boy.
Yes, I know that's not best practice.
Well, give them all to Dan, I don't know. I would never.
Yes.
I've always got to keep some goodies for myself.
I haven't hounded him about his shelf in a while.
Back.
Clearly some hounding.
Back, I say. You want your data back or what?
Jake's working on the vault recovery still. Actually, it's going really well. Massive shout out Wendell, by the way, from Level 1 Techs. What are the odds this is gonna work?
100%.
Yeah, I don't think so, Andy. Come on. Oh, perfect, it works. Never use admin and password, please, guys. Do as I say, not as I do. Login password is too weak. Oh, wait, it still let me do it. That'd be great if a guy just like popped out of the bottom and was like, weak! Apparently out of the box, it's configured for 6 GHz backhaul, which makes a ton of sense. Most people go wireless because they don't want to run wires through their home. But if it was me, man, I would find a way to run that wire because your Wi-Fi experience is going to be freaking amazing. Although you wouldn't have to do it immediately, right? Like you could run 6 GHz backhaul for now while you don't have any devices that can connect to it anyway, and then you can run your wire later once you actually feel like you need the extra speed. Oh, there it is. Extra slow showed up first. How ironic. Well, why don't we start with 2.4? This is a gigabit internet connection, so make of that what you will. Bum-bum. Obviously, this is not the most scientific way to do a wireless speed test, but in fact, I'm probably even too close to it.
Hi, YouTube.
It should be noted, we have a ton of RF junk in here. So if there's anywhere that I would expect this new 6 GHz band to make a difference, it would be in this office. Yeah, Linus Fast is not showing up here. Linus Slow is pretty fast, so that's cool. Dang! All right then, just shy of 800 megabit down. Looking at around, wow, okay. So Linus Slow, pretty fast. I'm confused though. I don't know why I can't see Linus Fast here. I'm gonna see if there's any firmware updates or anything. Oh, this is as good a time as any to poke around ASUS's dashboard here. So they've got their AI Mesh, which allows you to use multiple ASUS routers as mesh Wi-Fi system. It's really cool. It's a really neat way to bring forward your older devices and still get use out of them, especially if you have a larger home. Their AI protection, blocking malicious sites and cool stuff like that. Their parental controls were not amazing last time we tried them. Really good analysis tools though, so you can see traffic and clients and what apps are being used and stuff like that on your home network, especially if you have a family, that can be very useful. Firmware update, here we go. Okay, let's check. It's the latest version. Hold on a second, I'm gonna double check and make sure this is actually a 6E client then. Wi-Fi 6E, AX211. Linus Fast, not here. Well, I'm not gonna lie, I am at a total loss here, guys. Okay, yeah, I can't connect.
It's been a month during which time we figured out there are some issues around Wi-Fi 6E, 6 GHz, and Canada. So, magic! We are now connected at 6 GHz and I am ready to do my speed test. By the way, while this is running, shout out Rostine. It's a bit of a belated happy birthday, but in my defense, this video was delayed by factors that were outside of my control. Fortunately, nothing about this internet is delayed. That is gigabit freaking speeds over wireless, ladies and gentlemen. Look, I'll prove it. I'm gonna unplug this wire. Oh my God, it's dead. Oh my God, this page has so many ads on it. The point is, look, Ma, no wires.
I want Wi-Fi 6E all to myself. I mean, I guess that's the point, isn't it? You don't have to share. This is crazy. Like full line gigabit speeds just about wirelessly. Man, I want to change the server. There's a, man, what's that really good one locally? Yeah, no, urban fiber's not better today. I mean, I can go a little farther away because I'm imagining 6 GHz is not gonna do that great. Oh crap. I mean, it's not super scientific. We're gonna have a lab for that soon. Here, do you wanna show how far away we are?
How many bananas is it?
Oi! Oh, bananas. They're not a measure of distance, they're a measure of size, Jono. And you can check them out on lttstore.com. Anyway, the point is, we're gonna kinda, I don't know, let's go on the other side of a wall. You know, let's see. Is it gonna just completely get annihilated by one wall? Nope. Okay, well, let's go find another wall then. Oh, okay, this is not what I expected. We are now have a good solid couple of walls between us and we are still doing nearly 900 megabit per second. Brandon, can you navigate this? Going on a little voyage of discovery here.
Okay, when you talk, you gotta face me, Lance.
Oh, sorry, Brandon.
I'm going behind the sets.
Okay, all right, we got three walls and we finally dropped, oh, okay, it's still doing
good. Linus, face me.
Sorry. Okay, this is also better than I was hoping to show that it would like suck after a bit, because like 6 GHz or whatever. Yeah, that's, the upload's finally suffering a little bit. We've got three walls between us now. But that download though, like what?
You good, Brandon?
Yep.
Do you need help?
Ah.
Do you need help, Brandon?
I'm good.
Hi, Andy.
Hello.
Do you want to see my Wi-Fi?
Your Wi-Fi?
It's Wi-Fi 6E, and it's really fast.
It's like way over on the short circuit set.
Who needs cable?
Well, okay. No, there's still a value to wire. Stop. He knows better.
Face me, Linus.
Sorry. I'm going all the way to the thing. Oh, hey, sup, Dan.
Hey.
Look at this guy. He's like, oh, I'm working. Okay, did we finally lose it? We finally lost it. That's pretty darn good. Just like we lost this sponsorship with ASUS now that we're showing it failing at the end of the video. Haha, just kidding. Thanks ASUS for sponsoring this video. You can check out the ET12 at the link down below and subscribe to Short Circuit.